Hello, my name is Joshua James.
I'm Chris,
the oWoFan19 Hall of Famer.
Oh, almost dropped it.
And welcome to oWoFan19. Hello everybody, once again, my name's Josh.
I'm Chris.
And this is episode 51. Down to 51 episodes now.
Down to?
Whatever, doesn't matter. We got 51 episodes. So right now, once again, welcome back to the show, Chris Southerns. It's great to have you back on the show.
It's good to be back. Good to be back in Oregon.
Well, I bet. Where have you been?
I've been in Arkansas, and for a while I was in Washington.
Where in Washington?
Tri-Cities area, Pasco, Kennewick.
El Paso?
No, Pasco.
Pasky? Oh, Pasco.
Yeah, there was a lot of Mexicans there.
Sierra Hotel, India, Echo, Lima, Delta, Shield.
The Shield breaking up. Your thoughts on that?
I think it'll help Dean Ambrose. The other two, not so much. But it'll definitely help Dean Ambrose become more of an independent wrestler, and hopefully they'll finally start to use his mic skills. Because everybody knows, I mean, if you showed me some of the promos. If anybody's seen some of the promos from his indie wrestling days, he's not being used to the full potential of what he can do.
He could talk. He could talk on the mic.
If he gets rid of the Shield, he'll be able to do what he can finally do.
Do you think he'll finally get the push there? Really deserves become WWE world champion?
He can do heavyweight or he can do WWE champion, either one, but I think he deserves one of the big titles.
Is the WWE title, which is really sad about the world title, actually.
Yeah, because the heavyweight title doesn't, it's kind of like the US title right now, it doesn't really mean anything.
Sad.
Yeah.
But what do you think if they do split up? What do you think's gonna happen to Roman and Seth?
Well, I heard right now they're doing what is it called? The corporation?
The new corporation.
I wouldn't mind seeing Goldust come back. Either one, he's gonna do Goldust. I don't think he's allowed to do Rain.
No, that's TNA. Bro.
Yeah, that's TNA. But
I would love to see. It was his creation, but still,
if they bring Goldust back, maybe they should try to get another a good hardcore title thing going on instead of the 24-hour thing. I did like that, but it's what ruined the title because nobody took it seriously.
Goldust did.
He did. He held it how many times?
Six times, I think.
But I definitely like the idea of Goldust coming back if the Shield loses.
There's rumors that it's going to be for the tag team titles.
Goldust, that's the only other titles he's held is the tag team.
He only held the tag team titles once, and that was with Booker T. Too. What do you think about the idea?
After the first one, I definitely thought there was going to be a second one, so...
But did you expect Undertaker was going to be in it?
No, I didn't think that, but it makes sense. I mean, wrestling fans will get a kick out of it since, you know, Kane and Undertaker have done a lot of things with each other.
What about the Wyatt family? What's your thoughts on them?
Well, I hope to God they made some last minute changes to 2K14 to put them in there.
They're not in the game.
They're not? Well,
The Shield is.
Creator.
I will, but here's the thing. They might be DLCs.
And I don't think there's a might about it. I think they will be DLCs. And with how popular they've gotten in just the last few months. Like, they've only been there since August or so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And their promos, my god, they're
that,
well
done. That Bray Wyatt, he's a creepy guy.
You don't want to see him in a dark alley.
I want to see him in a horror movie. We should put him in one of those backwoods ones. You know,
like Texas Chainsaw Massacre, sort of, a little bit.
No,
if you saw his house, you would think it's a Texas Chainsaw Massacre house.
I wouldn't say Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I'd say more of a, you know, hillbillies find you while you're camping.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
But this time, you actually, but those other ones, not very scary, but he can actually make it scary.
He's scary looking himself without talking, just seeing his eyes. And
well, he talks now. He does promos. It's just his boys in the back. They don't talk.
Oh, yeah. They don't need to. They're scary enough, though, especially coming out with that, what is it, like a lamb or a sheep head or something?
Sheep head.
Oh, yeah.
Halloween 3D. Your thoughts?
I will not watch it. I think 3D is a stupid gimmick. Except for Avatar. Avatar was good in 3D.
Definitely.
But I don't want to watch it because I know for a fact Rob Zombie's not directing it.
He's not.
He refused because they've already asked him. And I believe he's been asked to do a new remake of Nightmare on Elm Street as well.
And Stephen King's It.
Do what?
Stephen King's It. Remember? Pennywise the Clown?
Yes, he was also offered It, and I believe he took It instead of Nightmare on Elm Street.
He did. He took Stephen King's It more.
He got a couple of offers, and that's the one he decided to do was It. And I'll go see that, but I ain't watching another Halloween remake.
I'll probably go see it. Wrestling Society X.
WSX.
Yep. Wrestling Society X. Now, I don't know if that's supposed to be like an independent wrestling company or something like that, but I really enjoyed Wrestling Society X.
Yeah, it only lasted for one season. I mean, they filmed for a second season, but it never was on air. I think it came on like a bonus DVD or something.
It did.
Yeah. But, I think it was like bought out or something, and which wouldn't be surprising because they had the opportunity, definitely an opportunity to overshadow WWE.
Oh yeah, definitely. I think the whole point of that show was to start the rivalry with X-Pac or Six-Pac with the Vampiro, Ricky Banderas, and Youth Suicide. Those four was supposed to face each other for that WSX title. I think that would have been great.
I was liking the one fact that it kind of seemed like it was trying to rebirth ECW almost, but with special effects.
But I found out Paul Heyman was entertained by the show. He loved it.
It was something fresh because nobody had ever decided, hey, why don't we take these fireworks that we use for entrances, screw the entrance, and use them for during the match.
Yeah, like
explosions and electricity.
The Piranha match, that one,
I'm not saying it worked every time, but they were new, so they could mess up a couple times.
Yeah, but the Piranha match was kind of odd and kind of terrifying at the same time, because those Piranhas eat fast.
I found the exploding casket match pretty hilarious.
I did too.
that was funny. Like I said, it was hit and miss, you know. Their tag team division was amazing.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, you got D-I-F-H, which is doing it for her. Los Papos, Guapos, whatever, how you say their name in Spanish. The Cartel. Team Dragon Gate.
Team Dragon Gate. They were, I remember the announcer just saying, I can't call anything. They do it too fast.
I know. They even watch some of their matches in Japan and they... Oh wait, there is one more question I want to ask you. Ultimate Warrior. Your thoughts on him when he did that trailer for WWE 2K14. Do you think that's a sign of him coming back?
I would love to see him come back. It's definitely a sign that he's made some sort of, you know, amends or apologies have been made.
Well, he didn't apologize. Vince did.
Well, isn't that what he wanted?
Yes.
Well, there you go. I mean, hopefully it's a start to not a mediocre return, but some sort of return.
Yeah, there's rumors going around that Hulk Hogan and Warrior made amends too. Do you think that's true? Let's hope, because they're supposed to be at the 30th WrestleMania.
Hopefully Hogan doesn't wrestle.
He doesn't wrestle, he can't wrestle.
But Ultimate Warrior looks like he could probably still kick some ass.
Yeah, he wrestled a couple years ago. He faced Orlando Jordan and held his first championship belt in over 10 years.
I'd love to see Ultimate Warrior come back for a couple matches, maybe get some old school, you know, do a Warrior versus the Legend, you know what I'm talking about? A little WrestleMania. You know, his Warrior title versus the undefeated streak.
Everybody wants to see Warrior face Taker at WrestleMania.
I would love it, especially if it's put some special stipulation on it or something, you know, like a casket or steel cage or something
like that. But I think it would be.
It can't just be. Even if it was a normal match, it'd be good, but you need that extra.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this episode, having my good friend and Hall of Famer of oWoFan19, Chris Southerns. Thank you for coming back, my friend.
Are you okay? Yeah, I got a holding in a cough there.
Okay. You're alright.
I think it's about time to tap out.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Joshua James.
I'm Chris.
And we are
tapping out.
See you later. I can see my fan.